I do this for every Trinidadian. Wield the mic in hand like weapons of an Asgardian. If you want to cross my line, take your time. I will direct you. Seek some advice from Dr. Kevorkian. I drop this on the station. The rotation is as much as when the circus play organs and the accordions. You ain't got no venom, use a pseudoscopy. And you diss me and I embarrass you in front of your audience. Tell them that I'm the West Indian. Same level as the French Merovingian. I am the IOS, you are just a symbian. I will meet you anywhere, like an amphibian. You see me black as night. Represent rain and the black and white. Cross me a snatch for your second life. Make you ride like a second hand bike. I'm from a tough West Indian jungle lord. Born cool, but I built to rumble. Please don't ever mistake my humble for weakness. For you surely will get tumble. I swear. Let me see your hands up in the air. Everybody put them up. Let me see your hands up high. I'm from the WI.
So we are getting ready for the second game in our doubleheader, match number 8 in the CFU Under 20 tournament, as it is consisting of the teams Aruba against Haiti. And this time it's Gregory Barris once again alongside Mr. Gordon Pear. And Gordon, this is a game of the two winners in this group so far.
Well, both teams have won on the first match day, so they're getting ready for the action in the second game. It's going to be very important. Both teams will want to get to the top of the list and secure their place in the next round of qualifying stage.
And as we see how vital victory is, as we just saw previously, the Dominican Republic achieving a 3-1 win against St. Kitts and Nevis. And now they have the points that they need, but unfortunately for St. Kitts and Nevis, it's bye-bye.
Well, it's more or less bye-bye. They still have a slim chance, according to the result of this game, because if Haiti is or any one of these teams to get a positive result, they will go to 6 points, so there will be two teams on three. So technically, mathematically, as the professionals say, St. Kitts would still have a slim chance.
Yeah, we'll all go down to goal difference, and the goal difference is not really in St. Kitts and Nevis' favor as we watch the two teams come out to the field.
We see them just getting out on the pitch.
Aruba looking primed and ready for this one. So are Haiti. And this has all the makings of an exciting match, because for this one, the winner of this one will get a place in the next round.
Yeah, definitely. Remember, they're playing here for a chance to go to the Under 20 World Cup. That's to be held next year in New Zealand. But the top four teams, they go forward to counter CAF. That's going to be a qualifying tournament in January of 2015.
And as we see the teams lined up on the field, we get ready for the national anthems. And the first one we will hear is the national anthem of Aruba. Anthem of Aruba. We're getting excited, and now we see the Haitian national anthem about to take place. Both teams coming together there. The Haitians and the Arubans doing the handshakes there. As we get a look at the team news for both countries. For Aruba, we see Jean-Marc Antisson, who had an incredible game against St. Kitts Nevis in the last game. He starts again with Carl German, Nicholson Paul, Joel German, the captain, Jonathan Ruiz, Giorgio van der Biesen, Walter Burnett, Duncan Homewet, Ricky Hodge, Marcel Koch, and Franklin Ortiz Carbacas as the starting 11 for the Aruban national team. They are looking to see if they can book a place in the next round with them. And the coach for them is Veron Alberts of the Netherlands. For the Haitians, we see in goal is Sanan Steve. And we look at the defense for the outfield players is Lambie Stefan, Dimas Fernandez, St. Fort Vanel, Desiree Jonel, Sharon Font, Vundeski, Campoy Alessandro, Jean Becker Jean-Baptiste, the captain, Ezilin Fritz, and Paul Narkendel, the vice captain, and Junior Peterson Joseph, who also had a very interesting game last time, as he was a goal scorer in the last game. So, a very attack-minded setup for both teams here.
Well, both teams are going to go for the win. When you look at the bench, though, you see both teams are coached from European coaches. On the Aruba side, we have a coach, Mr. Albertes, from the Netherlands. And for Haiti, we have Jerome Felford from France.
As we see the two captains posing with the referee and his assistants. The referee is Johannes Dolagny from Suriname. And his assistants are Ainsley Rochard from Trinidad, Ramon Louisville from Suriname as well. And the fourth official is Moise Games from St. Vincent.
Well, this game promises to be a cracker. The Haitian teams, they are in red, and they will be kicking from right to left on your screen. Aruba, they're in their yellow and blue.
So both teams pretty much going through their paces here. Linesmen checking the goalkeeping nets. We're just making sure that everything is in place for what promises to be an exciting match. It is Aruba against Haiti. The winner will advance in the next round of the CFU Under-20 tournament. This is match number 8 in the doubleheader today in the CFU Under-20 at the Atol Boldin Stadium here in Couva on a nice night. Both teams will like the conditions here, a lot cooler than the heat that they would have to deal with in the earlier matches.
Yeah, and the pitch looks a pit here. Here we see standing over the ball the number 19, Junior Joseph, as well as the number 9.
Desiree Jonel.
Jonel.
Both players looking geared up and ready to go. As we are underway in this match, the Haitians clad in all red and the Aruban team in blue and yellow. And they will be looking for both teams to really start off. And if the first match was any indication, we could see a lot of goals.
Well, definitely this game will be very interesting. Both teams having gotten victories in the first round of games in this tournament. Haiti achieving a 2-1 victory against St. Kitts and Aruba. No, Aruba against St. Kitts and Haiti getting that result against the Dominican Republic.
That's correct, and they were both identical score lines, mind you. So we see the Aruban team really getting into the paces, trying to move around, and a bit of a change in strip from the last game that they had. As we see the passing coming together nicely. Aruba trying to get some movement together, trying to settle. A very quick team, the Arubans. Very nice style to their game. A bit of a, you could say, almost a total football kind of style, as most Netherlands coaches will try to incorporate in the team play.
Well, definitely. I've yet to see them play in the tournament, so it's my first look at them. Judging from what I heard, though, I hear the keeper is Lightning. Very exciting prospect.
Jean-Marc Antisson. Really a very incredible goalkeeper, as he had a very wonderful match-winning save to make in the end of their match against St. Kitts Nevis.
The Haitian team, they though, will bring a sense of athleticism, as there we see them attacking down the left side.
Yes, and I believe that is the number 6 for them.
Yeah, that's putting on.
There's Fernandez, Dimas Fernandez, trying to get him, trying to get movement going. Haitians are a very exciting team, mind you. They are a team that like to counter, and they know how to catch you with it. They are a very pacey side. As we see Fernandez trying to make something happen, but unfortunately, nothing going there. As we see the ball played ahead for Homewet, but easy pickings for Sanan Steve, the goalkeeper for Haiti. Both teams will be a little cautious in the start, as they know want to give away any early goals, as we saw in the earlier match where St. Kitts got the early goal in the third minute, but it didn't see to do any damage as the Haitians are breaking away here, but just only getting away with that one. But it breaks back to them. Can they make something from this play this time? And the ball bouncing around in the box, still not cleared properly, and a scuff shot really getting away as the Rubens will finally clear the ball. That's played over.
Steve coming a long, long way there.
Off of his line, really.
Coming a long, long way, doing well, just clearing the ball into touch.
I guess he watched Uzal Hodge earlier and saw how he played for the St. Kitts Nevis team. And let's just say that's not something that would be highly recommended for most goalkeepers to do. Because one bad kick and somebody could be taking a ball over your head.
Especially in this surface. The surface just had a bit of water on it. The ball just seemed to bounce and skid. May just come on a bit quicker.
Yes, and it may make for some very slippery conditions here for goalkeepers when they do have to make any saves. As we see a bit of a tussle there in the middle between two players from Aruba and Haiti, and it's a free kick to Aruba.
So both teams yet to really settle. Just about 3 minutes gone in this one.
Yeah. And if you remember, as I said earlier, 3 minutes already into this game, we saw in the earlier match, St. Kitts already had the lead. But we see a bit more composure from this team as we see Carl Germain for Aruba holding the ball up. And Nicholson Paul, who was outstanding in the back for Aruba in the last game, really helped marshal the defense. And there's Van der Biesen, who himself was oppressive, and unfortunately not his best moment there, as Haiti may have a chance here. And yeah, just trickles wide.
Me.
That is the number 10.
No, that's the number 10. He Sharon was Fons. Begging for the ball in the middle of the pitch.
Sharon Fontenwardensky.
I think it's the number 9 there. Who? 19.
Actually, it is the number 19, yes. Junior Peterson Joseph, who was a bit of a spark in the last game against the Dominican Republic.
Well, he's showing signs of life, just not getting the ball on target there, but he has already created two half chances against this Aruban team.
Yes, and Aruba will be wary of his abilities. I'm sure that Verón Alberts has probably put in their mind to keep an eye on him, as he could be one of the danger men for this team. Haiti, not any slouches at all. They have a history of being a team that will catch you off guard with an early strike. As we see a ball played over, Homewet trying to see if he can get a hold of it. Ricky Hodge on the side there, but nothing going there as the defense steps up, and we will see our first corner of the game.
So that's Nikaden.
Kendall.
Kendall. Just putting the ball into touch. So the big guys from the back come up for Aruba.
Yes, and it is Ricky Hodge, who was very impressive in his last game against St. Kitts Nevis, running at them continuously throughout the game. He can be a bit of a testing one for the Haitians.
So he's going to take this one with the left boot. It's going to be curling in.
Yeah, we see some of the players coming up. He's signaling that the corner could be coming in soon. And the Haitians need to really keep an eye out.
Normally when the hand goes up, it means he's going for the back post. So let's look at it. It's at the back post.
And nobody there to pick up on it, really. A wasted corner.
Wasted corner. Earlier on, though, you saw the hand went up. So that's an indication normally.
Yeah, then you usually would have to pay attention. That would be football 101, wouldn't you say, Gordon?
Yes, definitely. Coaches and players who play a lot, we know when they're going to go back post. So if you're pointing to the ground, normally you're going to go at the first post.
Yeah, Verón Alberts not really too pleased with what he was seeing there from his Aruban team, as he will hopefully expect a better performance throughout the remainder of the game. So far, it's a throw in here to Aruba, 6 minutes in. And the second of the doubleheader here at the Atom Bolden Stadium. And Aruba versus Haiti. This one could be for a good mean advancement, and it could be a bit of a setback for whoever loses this game.
Definitely, both teams will be going for the result. Both teams also will not like to lose here tonight, because even a draw, I think it's going to set them up very nicely. A draw will eliminate St. Kitts.
Yes, mathematically, they would be making it a lot harder for them and virtually impossible for them to do anything, as a free kick comes in for Aruba. I believe it's Van der Biesen trying to whip it in.
Man goes down in the box. No call by the referee.
Not really looking at it as a deliberate foul on any of the players. As we see, the Arubans trying to move around. One player they have to watch, they have to really look at for throughout this game, and it's a nasty bit of a shoulder charge there, as the referee is allowing it to play. We've noticed a bit of leniency from some of these referees with the play.
Well, I think, you know, the referees have been given the mandate there.
Look at the replay here. It was Homoet who was the man that was taken down.
Barged over there by...
Yes, by not Kendall.
Kendall just barging him over.
Yes, and they can expect a very rough night. Like we said, the theme throughout this tournament has been a bit of an aggressive style to most of the teams that are playing.
Pick it up in the midfield. They are working the ball really around beautifully.
See Campoy Alessandro for Haiti. Moving the ball around here. Maybe look. Nice. That is St. Fort Vanel. Trying to get forward. Going there. It's a nice ball inside. Can I get something? Here it's in!
No, it's not.
Oh, my goodness. And
the
it's offside.
It's up on the far side.
Just when it looked like the Haitians had an early breakthrough.
But a beautiful build-up play. I love to see that again. There we saw footed on. Getting it at the back post.
Yes. It would be. It was a very nice move there by Dimas Fernandez to come in. We're going, do you think that's an early sign, though?
I think the Haitian team showing signs of life early on here. They have been pressing, looking to create chances. This Aruban team, though, I realize they are very quick on the counter-attack.
As we see
but
a chance
here
coming
Haiti
in.
Here comes again. And a shot just wide.
Wonderful effort there by Alessandro. Campoy Alessandro running and menacing forward. As we look at the replay here, we look at his movement. Nicely lined up, just not getting it on target, Gordon.
I think it's a bit of a deflection. They're going to get a corner.
And we see the Haitians really signaling their intent as they go on. Aruba really have to be on their guard.
Ferdinand goes across. There he's going to be taking this with the left boot.
What can Haiti muster up from this corner? This could be an important moment and a breakthrough that they needed. They really have been showing their intent.
A bit of tussling.
Oh, and it's a nice playback for Alessandro, but he can't do anything with that. As the Rubens break away with it, they're trying to find something. Homewood and Hodge are the only two players up front. Homewood trying to see if he can get control of it. He does get control. He's still turning around, and I think this will be a corner kick to Aruba.
So end-to-end action here after that cautious start earlier on. Both teams now throwing their punches. Really holding nothing back, these two teams. And I think sooner rather than later, we're going to have an opening goal.
Yeah, San and Steve trying to talk to his defenders to make sure that they keep their eyes open.
And that's another sign there. The man going to take the corner, he just bounced the ball on the ground. Yeah, so he's going to be looking for somebody coming in on the first post.
Yeah, making sure he can get some flight on it, really. Hopefully that they can make something out of this. The Arubans can be dangerous from these kind of set plays.
Here we see the coach up.
Yes, that's Jerome Velfert, the
Haitian coach.
Yes.
But I'm sure he knows that signal as well. The bounce ball on the ground. So it's going to be aimed at the first post. He does.
Oh, it's a header that's bouncing around and nothing going there. As the Haitians try, it's a nice flick, but not getting any further. As it's tried to play back in. It's brought down, bouncing around, and nobody can really get control. And it will be a foul there for Vernel. And it'll be a free kick for Aruba.
So bailed out there by the referee. The referee goes across, tells Burnett, take it down.
See, it's a free kick to Haiti, rather. Dimas Fernandez trying to get something out of this. Muscling off his opponent, and that could be a free kick. Well, it's a throw-in, rather. Referee not deeming that as bookable.
The referee, the player has stayed down.
Yes, I believe that's Ricky Hodge on the ground there.
Rolling in pain.
A bit of a nasty challenge he took there from Fernando with the elbow. Actually, it's Homoet is the player that's been taken down, the number 10 for Aruba. This has all the makings of a very intense match. As we look on 11 minutes in, it's 0-0. But there has been some signals of intent so far from both teams, Gordon.
Definitely both teams looking to get forward. And here we see the Haitian team coming again.
Not the best of executed passes as they get away with it easy. It's played up, long ball.
Just really banged up field, long and hopeful. Stevie's going to come to the edge of his box and just plays it with his feet.
He's getting the team together as they're trying to move the ball around. He's been really having to do much more talking to his defense as we see the Haitians menacing forward yet again, and not really much happening there, as Anderson not having too much work, as we see. Get a shot of the crowd there. A lot of people watching this with a bit of excitement.
That seems to be the Dominican Republic team there, probably doing a bit of scouting.
Yes,
and there's a foul called right at the very corner of the field.
Yeah, and Alessandro trying to do what he can to get forward, but knocked off the ball easily. And you figure for the Dominican Republic, they're looking at this and they're saying to themselves, they're watching what they're up against.
I think the Haitian team, they have decided they're going to be going down that right-hand side.
Yes. And we see Alessandro is the one that's going to whip it in. And we see a complaint from one of the Aruban players. That is Jonathan Ruiz, the captain. And it's brought back out by Aruba.
But he should get it again.
Alessandro again, just making sure he stays on side. Nice whipped in cross. Fernandez!
Oh,
wonderful finish!
Oh, the volley! My goodness me!
Dimas Fernandez giving the Haitians the goal that they needed. What a finish! What a volley good!
Beautiful football there. You know, Alessandro, full points to him. He got the ball back, a pinpoint cross, and put it on, banging it past goalkeeper.
Sweetly struck, really. You could have seen that he knew what he was doing. Very well taken. Took a bounce there, and Anderson unlucky just to get a hand on it, but not doing enough as the Haitians go forward by a goal to nil. And if the scoreline stays like this, they will be booking their place in the next round.
Definitely. But what a sweetly taken on the volley there.
And only in the Under-20 World Cup will you see moments like this, ladies and gentlemen. We are looking at a very intense match. The best start here for the Haitians. 15 minutes in, and it is Aruba nil, Haiti 1. As the Arubans are looking for a quick response there, but not really getting anything. But again, what a finish by Dimas Fernandez.
Definitely. The keeper, Jean-Marc Austin, he had no chance at all. Just, he wondered what flew past in there.
I don't even think that he saw the ball fly past him. He just probably put his hands out in hope, really, trying to stop something.
But here comes the Haitian again, trying to get that ball going. They have decided that they're going to be going down the right-hand side and probably looking for Fernando to come in.
They are being menacing at the moment. That goal will give them a bit of a confidence boost. As we see the number 15, that's Jean-Baptiste, the captain, trying to make sure and marshal his troops. It's a nice looping ball coming forward. We could see Peterson coming in here. Well, it's played off, and they won't get anything out of that one. But the Aruban team are now going to be on their toes for the remainder of this game. They do not want to concede another one like that.
Well, the back four seems to be at sea at present. They're having difficulties really curtailing the Haitians. This Haitian team very fast, very physical. And there we see an example of it again.
It's a very hard tussle there in the middle as they're trying to get something. But the Aruba's doing very well to keep them out. Fernandez slipping. He's trying to get forward. And that could be a foul there, but the referee's allowing it to play on. And there he finally calls it. This one looks a little bit nasty.
So Carl German, he's going to be the first man to go into the referee's book.
Yes, and it's a yellow card for Carl German. You better be careful. Accumulation, and he could miss the next game.
Definitely.
That is
just taking out the player. Just taking out the player from the back there. He has stayed down. That's the number 10.
Yes, that is Wodenski.
Wodenski.
And it wasn't the best of knocks. He's getting some treatment. But, like I said, a trend that has been going throughout the remainder of this tournament, the majority of this tournament, has been very physical play. These youngsters are very, very aggressive.
That's the age group, friendly. Hold no punches.
16 minutes into this match, and we see a very, very intense game so far. This is the second game of the group stage for both of these teams. There we see Wodenski dropping back a bit.
He's back up on his feet. Good to see the young man.
Yes, and we see them trying to make some passes together. Jean-Baptiste going out wide on the right. He's pushing it, and they're trying to see if they can get something, a long ball forward. Ball played down nicely. Showing some strength, but I think it's a bit aggressive there, and it will be a free kick. The number 9 for Haiti, that is Desiree Jonel, is the guilty party from that.
free kick in a very interesting position here for the Haitian team.
And Alessandro, you see, standing around the ball. He may be the man to put it in. But then again, Fernandez, who has shown that he has a good shooting foot.
Fernandez, he's going to take it with the left boot. I think it's perfect for him there. He just needs to go up and over the wall.
Yeah, so this is about probably 25 yards out.
Just about. Alexandro still not going away. He seems to be very interested as well. The number 14.
We could see a training ground routine here. I've seen a lot of those coming on between both of the around a lot of the teams so far, doing a lot of set plays, a lot of rolling the ball across. And we see as Alessandro with the dummy. It is Fernandez. Rolls around to the box, but nobody doing anything. And it falls back to Vernel, who plays it back out. It goes out wide here. He's looking for the players are looking for options. They're calling for it. He goes around trying to see if he can get to it, but nothing given.
So it's going to be another corner for the Haitian team.
Yes, and they will like that. They want to keep putting pressure on the Aruban team as much as they can.
And the referee doing some talking too.
Yes, it's Nicholson Paul he's having a word with, making sure that he straightens the matters out and wants no nonsense from anybody on in this game. Referees have been fair but tough. You need that.
That's their job. You see going across the goal scorer.
It's Fernandez again. He wants to. He's in the middle of everything right now.
Right. Oh, he's there in the middle of the pot.
It's a short corner kick. Alessandro giving it back to Fernandez, who may be looking for an option to whip it back in and just making sure Nicholson Paul not allowing anybody to get a hold of that as Wodenski was just lurking right on the edge of the 6 yard.
Yeah, Wodenski there just waiting, praying that it was a misheader.
Look at the replay here again. Fernandez really being lively for them. Wodenski was just about waiting for that ball to come to his head. Nicholson Paul, it's the same tactic again. Another short corner. Fernandez playing it low this time. It's a nice chance, Alessandro. Nice 1-2. Alessandro can turn and shoot. And it's two.
Beautiful goal, Alessandro. So Alessandro and put it on. Really. Team it up.
Link it together very nicely. Campoy Alessandro with his goal makes it 2-0 for the Haitians. And they are alive in this one. Surely stating their intention.
Jonel there. Nice interpassing by the Haitians. Back to Alessandro. The turn and the one-time finish with the left boot.
Very well done there. Campoy Alessandro doubling the lead for his team. And right now, Jerome Velfair is a happy man.
Definitely. So just 20 minutes gone in this one. Haiti already lead 2-0.
Aruba have a lot of work to do from here.
And I'm saying it looks very difficult for them to come back from this one. Early days yet.
Here's Ricky Hodge trying to see if he can get something. But Fernandez staying with him. Fernandez really has been Mr. Energy.
Well, Fernandez has been providing a lot of energy, but Alessandro, he has been involved in everything as well. He provided a pinpoint cross that Fernandez blasted home, and there, sharing a nice 1-2 with the second goal between him and Junel, and bang it home with the left boot. So Haiti, building from the back.
Really, this is the kind of a standard that you need to see from a lot of teams. You're looking at that, they're taking their chances, they're making sure that they do enough to make them count, keeping the pressure up on the Arubans, and making sure they don't have really much of a chance to execute anything by their defense. So far, you can see that San and Steve has had very little to do between those two goals. And we see a free kick here taking place for the Haitians. They could make it three.
So the same two guys, there we see the coach of the Haitian team,
yes,
the referee assistant.